What are you looking at? All you are is a failure.
Sunshine, won't she be my mother? Sunshine, come and help me see.
I shouldn't be here. I went through 2 foster homes and 2 group homes before I was 16 years old. I actually quit school and worked at McDonald's for a year, and I left home at 17. School was hard. I was the ugly one, the dumb one, the nerd. Anything that I wanted to do or tried to do was met with the same sounds. All you are is a failure. The F word was planted as part of my identity. Failure. There was one thing I was recognized for. When I was 10, I won an acting award. It was the end of the school year assembly. Our class was about to do a play called The Night of the Werewolf. I was the narrator. My principal, Mr. Holt, presented me with the award and announced to the crowd,
"You will hear Kevin on the radio one day."
I loved the radio. I listened to it all the time. Being from Calgary, I would listen to Flames games late at night.
Back there's McCowan to get it, and it is a nice icing call against Montreal.
Even played table hockey tournaments, and I was the play-by-play person. Be my destiny. Go to school, go to college, get on radio. Except, it took me 30 years to do it. How does a guy who has this so-called voice for radio wait until his 40s to pursue his dream? What held him back? This is my story. It's the 90s. The Gulf War happened. The first of the 2 George Bushes being president. OJ and the White Congo. Nirvana. And while my friends were going through post-secondary and establishing what they wanted to do in life, I was doing the only thing someone without a high school diploma and quit school at 16 could do.
Is George there? Hello? Hi there, my name is Kevin, and I'm calling on behalf of... Hello? Hi, my name is Kevin, I'm calling on behalf of... Hello? Hi there, my name is... Hello?
Thought telemarketing is a mind-sucking, soul-crushing, loserville type of job. I did it for 7 years. Telemarketing? What a loser! Telemarketing? What a loser! Something inside me needed more, and it was coming.
There, that is the World Trade Center, and we have unconfirmed reports this morning that a plane has crashed into one of the towers of the World Trade Center.
Watched on live TV as planes hit buildings. I didn't go to work that day. I did the next day.
Are you dumping fucking calls? Are you literally not doing a thing? You're fucking fired!
Fucking failure.
Maybe 6 feet is so far down.
It's hard to believe that a human being with a lousy high school record and no post-secondary would be able to work at a post-secondary school. My sense of value grew. My fashion sense grew. I gained a sense of identity, or what we call these days a brand or a personality. I was maybe sort of, kind of cool. I came up with an idea. Welcome to Agree or Disagree, the podcast. I interviewed people about politicians. I started debates and I created conversation. I went on the Ryan Jesperson show at 6:30 Chet in Edmonton. It was a great opportunity, but it also became a big lesson because I watched an actual professional do a show, how to handle a microphone, how to talk on the microphone, how to speak clearly. I did none of those things, and I needed that. I lived right across the street from my work. I was making a public sector salary. I had it all. Job security, safety, comfort. It really couldn't get much better than that. But podcasting, microphone.
Come on, that's a delivery. Back to Crete, shoot, save one. And it's one more day up in the canyon. And it's one more night in Hollywood. It's so long since I seen the ocean. I guess I should.
Opportunity seize everything you ever wanted in one moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo, his palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy.
Dan Arts, a 1-year program, September to September, and I loved every minute of it. I mean, yeah, sex is cool, but have you actually been a host of a radio show? Good. And I graduated. I was done school. I was ready to go. My destiny awaited. I applied for over 200 jobs. I could not get anywhere. Nowhere interviews. Got something. Kamloops. I was going to be a producer of a new talk show format. It was for a morning show. Yeah, I had to get up really early, but I felt ready. Middle of May, I moved to Kamloops. It's the beginning of June. After 2 weeks of Airbnbs, I finally found a place to settle. That Wednesday, the boss brings me in for the morning meeting.
Look, Kevin, I know it's been difficult, but you just don't have the experience we're looking for. I'm sorry, but we're going to have to let you go.
You don't have any money for rent. We're going to be fine. Everything's going to be okay. You have to go to the food bank. Don't worry. We'll be fine. What are you doing? Shut up.
All you are.
Shut up.
Is a failure.
Shut up. Shut up!
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up.
Don't the hours go shorter as the days go by? Never get to stop and open our eyes. 1 minute you're waiting for the sky to fall.
And next you're back to Vancouver. I'm doing play-by-play for the Greater Vancouver Canadians. Occasionally I walk a dog. And yes, the same back in school for the same program I took before. As for him, let's be honest. You can share all the inspirational quotes about how failure is good for you, how failure grows you through adversity. But failure sucks, mentally, physically, emotionally. I shouldn't be here, but I am here. There is one thing that I have learned. Failure isn't trying not succeeding. Failure is not trying at all. So the F word that identifies me isn't failure.
It's fighter.
The shadow proves the sunshine.